52,000. That's about how many pieces I cooked of fish while working as chef de partie at Addison. We're going over the best techniques I know so that you can make better and cheaper fish than most restaurants. First, what fish to get. Frozen has the benefit of being less expensive and is normally cut and frozen out at sea. The downside is that the cryovac, which compresses the flesh, and also freezing allows the flesh to get dried out faster. Wild fish tends to have more flavor because of the diversity of diet, but is more expensive and is limited because of seasonality. My preferences when available is fresh wild king salmon, but the salmon I most commonly get is Faroe Islands, which is farmed Atlantic. Normally I like to portion the fish with even vertical cuts, but I lost a lot of salmon to trim. Ideally ask for center cut of fillet with the belly removed. Not to worry though, we will use the trim up later in the video, so stay tuned for that. To serve the salmon with the skin, run your knife in the opposite direction that the scales lay. This will remove any excess water and scales if there are any. Then scrape in the opposite direction to close up the skin. This is solely for presentation. If you want to serve without the skin, remove it by angling your knife at a 45 degree angle. Wiggle and separate. I will also show you later how to remove the skin after by cooking, which is way easier than doing it before. Season with salt. Pan seared. For this method, you want to use the salmon that we scraped the skin. Heat a saute pan up between medium high and medium heat with vegetable oil. Once the oil starts to shimmer, lay the fish away from you and hold down the fish to prevent it from curling with either a fish spatula or your fingers. Cook 85% on the skin side. You will know it's ready when it's golden brown and the sides release itself from the pan. Flip over and baste with oil or clarified butter. You never want to use whole butter on crispy skin. The water in the whole butter will cause the skin to get soggy. Pan seared salmon will have crisp spin and a boost in flavor from the Maillard reaction. It will slightly have more flavor, but a drier texture than the next two methods. Shallow poached. To start, we're gonna make court bouillon, but salted water will also work. For the court bouillon, wash half a leek and then chop it. Add one stick of celery, a bunch of thyme, parsley stems, whole peppercorns, 1 ounce of white wine vinegar, 8 ounces of water, and season with salt. Simmer this for 15 minutes, then strain. This can be used up to 3 times, but keep it frozen if you do not use it up within 3 days. Give it a taste and adjust the seasoning with salt and vinegar. Heat up the cuisson, which is French for cooking liquid, just below a simmer. Add the fish and be sure the liquid comes halfway up the salmon. Cook until the top of the salmon is just warm, about 7 minutes. White protein known as albumin will come out. Scrape it off. When albumin comes out of the fish, it normally is a sign that it's overcooked. That and it looks dry. Butter baked. This is salmon the Addison way and is personally my favorite. It also happens to be the easiest. We would start by salt curing it for 2 days. To do this, season the uncut fish just like you would do when you're about to cook it. Place it on a wire rack in the fridge, ideally for 2 days, but the fish will benefit from any time you give it. This will pull any excess water out, concentrating the flavor and firming up the texture. Place pats of butter in a pan, placing the salmon skin side down with butter on top. This method also works with olive oil instead. If you're using cured fish, do not season it before cooking. Bake at 225 degrees Fahrenheit. Height or 107 degrees Celsius for about 8 minutes. Larger pieces will take upwards of 14 minutes. You will know it's ready when the fish has the same color throughout and has some give when you squeeze it, but is tender enough to bite. With a butter or palette knife, peel away the skin, bloodline, and any albumin. This has a similar taste and texture to shallow poached, except it's slightly richer from the butter or olive oil, depending on what you use. Endive. To start, cut the bacon en lardons. You'll have an easier time if you freeze the bacon first. Cook the bacon on medium to render out the fat. The fat should be translucent, but the bacon should not have any color yet. Next, cut your apples into batonnet, 1/4 inch by 2 inches. The shape is not the important part though. The important part is that the cut is consistent. Thinly slice the endive and then saute until tender. Add 2 tablespoons of creme fraiche and some grated grano padano. Alternatively, you can add a squeeze of lemon juice and extra virgin olive oil. Béarnaise. Clarified butter has 75% yield, so plan on how much you need accordingly. Make the clarified butter, melt whole butter, remove the butter solids that float up to the top, and cook out the water. As the water cooks out, the temperature of the butter increases, forcing the water to evaporate faster and causing the bubbles to come up to the surface rapidly. Pull off on the burner and allow the residual heat to cook out the water. I save the butter solids to make a large batch of brown butter, place into a jar, and store in the freezer. To make the sabayon, which is the base of all hot egg emulsion sauce, fold a towel to create a stable base for the bowl. For every egg yolk, add 1 tablespoon of water and season with salt. Mix until combined, then place on a bain-marie. This is the French term for a double boiler and is created with 1 pot of simmering water in a bowl. Some will cook sabayon over direct heat. This has more room for air and creates less aeration, which is not what we're going for. Control the heat by moving the bowl back onto the towel. This will help prevent the sauce from curdling. The Sauvignon is ready when it's triple in volume and flows slowly back when you part it. In school, my chef called this parting the seas. Drizzle in the clarified butter, being sure to fully emulsify each ladle before adding the next. This will help prevent the sauce from breaking. The ratio for the clarified butter is 2 to 3 ounces per yolk. Some say to use whole butter, but I find sauces made with whole butter are looser and have less flavor. To make the reduction, slice 1 shallot, tarragon stems, cracked peppercorns with 60 milliliters each of white wine and white wine vinegar. Reduce by 2/3, then combine with the sauvignon and strain. Finish with chopped tarragon and salt if needed. I strained each separately because I made hollandaise and some derivatives. Video coming soon. The plate, lay down the endive and place the salmon of choice on top. I'm going with the shallot poached and garnish with tarragon leaves, pickled shallot, and cracked pepper, which are the flavors of the sauce. The most important thing about the garnish is that it should be edible and make sense with the flavors of the dish. Finish with sauce béarnaise. Now, it's time to use up some salmon trim. Let's make tartare. Remove the skin and pockets of fat. Dice up and in a bowl mix together with 2 tablespoons of creme fraiche, dill, preserved lemons, salt, and a squeeze of lemon juice. You can go with fresh lemon zest instead, but the preserved lemon is worth making. Place the tartare in a bowl and serve with toasted baguette. Next, you should check this video out.